The 50th anniversary of the Byrd Polar Research Center exhibition utilized more than just cases. A significant amount of time, talent, and technique helped to incorporate the wall space of the Thompson Library Gallery in order to enhance the exhibit. Several materials used in the exhibition required wall space due to their sheer size, such as the timeline that measures 38 feet long and the advertisement panels that are over 7 feet tall. Most of the early polar expeditions were privately funded, which meant that fundraising was also an important part of the job. Between expeditions, Admiral Richard E. Byrd spent time raising money through book sales and speaking engagements across the country. This advertisement measures 41 inches wide and 80 inches tall and promotes a lecture by Byrd accompanied with thrilling motion pictures. This event was most likely between the first and second Antarctic expeditions, with James B. Pond as Byrd's publicist. Admiral Byrd had a close funding relationship with General Foods, the makers of the cereal Grape Nuts, on the second Antarctic expedition. Byrd's weekly two-way radio broadcasts from Antarctica were made possible by General Foods, and a commemorative map was sent to consumers of Grape Nuts in exchange for box tops. Around the same time, Sir George Hubert Wilkins also took time to tour the country with lectures, photos, and artifacts from his Nautilus submarine expedition to the Arctic. This advertisement is so large that it had to be split into two 40-inch wide panels in order to be framed. The total dimensions for this hand-painted piece is 80 inches wide and 85 inches tall. Throughout the years, polar exploration and science has developed at an astounding rate. This timeline, originally created for a visit by former Vice President Al Gore to the Byrd Polar Research Center in 2003, shows the histories of Admiral Richard E. Byrd, Dr. Frederick A. Cook, Sir George Hubert Wilkins, and the Institute of Polar Studies, later renamed Byrd Polar Research Center. To add perspective, significant world events are also included. This visually engaging 38-foot-long timeline not only shows what these polar icons and the Byrd Polar Research Center have accomplished, but also how quickly we have scientifically and technologically advanced over the past 100 years, from the dawn of industrialization to NASA exploration. At approximately 10 feet wide and 8 feet tall, this large map of Antarctica is a striking representation of the impact of the Byrd Polar Research Center on the southernmost continent. The map was produced as part of the RADARSAT Antarctic Mapping Project, a NASA-sponsored project with special thanks to the Canadian Space Agency. On the map are 132 blue numbers that indicate geographic features named in honor of Ohio and Byrd Center members generated using ArcGIS software. These names are from the Composite Gazetteer of Antarctica, managed by SCAR and hosted by the Australian Antarctic Division, while the U.S. Board on Geographic Names website provided the information for the features. Posted to the left of this wall-sized map is a legend that gives the name, geographic feature, and exact location for each corresponding blue number. Some examples are number 87, Mercer Ice Stream, named after esteemed Byrd Center scientist John H. Mercer, and number 128, Buckeye Table, in honor of Ohio, the Buckeye State. Next to this large map is a photo of four Byrd Center members showing off their Ohio State spirit. This July 2008 photo was taken at a lake called Cuchiacocha in Cordillera Blanca, Peru. The members were undertaking field research to measure glacier volume changes and impacts to water resources in the mountain range, which contains the largest concentration of tropical glaciers on Earth. From left to right, Kyung In Hu, Sarah Fortner, Sarah Wright, and Brian Mark. A great deal of Byrd Center scientific research and fieldwork occurs beyond the poles, such as ice core drilling in Peru. Bruce Cosey and Carl Quivenin worked for the Polar Ice Coring Office and conducted ice core drilling in Peru. This handcrafted Peruvian patchwork llama rug, measuring 60 inches by 74 inches, originally given to Quivenin by Cosey in the late 1970s, was donated to the Byrd Polar Research Center in 2008 in Bruce Cozy's honor and memory. To the right of the llama rug hangs three small pictures of Cozy. This photo shows Bruce Cozy at left with Lonnie Thompson at the Calcaya Ice Cap in Peru, 1983. Here, Bruce Cozy at left and Carl Quivenin are shown at the South Pole circa 1980s. This photo shows Bruce Cozy, right, working with another scientist in the field circa 1980s. This National Geographic special on Antarctica features a front and back supplement to the February 2002 issue. One side features a segment about RADARSAT, the NASA project to map Antarctica via satellite, and discusses shifting shorelines and ice. The other side addresses Antarctica's atmosphere, geography, and ancient past. Many photos around the exhibition do not have captions, yet add to the overall celebration of scientific and Byrd Polar Research Center achievement. Fieldwork and exploration in these cold, remote regions have provided us with more than data and discovery. Their hard work has also given us a beautiful glimpse of an untouched continent that most of us will never see.